be a rough trip. Used to be to go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy. Half the city's dead of the plague. The other half's fighting over what's left. City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. A man walks through one of those, and he ends up burned to a crisp. Everything not controlled by the City Watch is gang territory. And there are the real odd birds living on the fringes, like that Granny Rags. They say she's nuts. Don't know which is worse. Just take your pick.
Let's go. It's nearly midnight. But easy, damn it. Keep... Canal's got enough shit in it as it is.
I think that last one was moving.
What? Yeah, the little one.
Not enough.
Or...
Sorry, I can't help you. I don't know this area well.
Good. Keep them coming.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. Report all deceased family members to the local dead counter. Unreported deaths are a punishable offense.
All these rats crawling all over.
Attention, Dunwall citizens. This is a special announcement from our honorable Lord Regent.
This is the Lord Regent.
It is with regret
that I announce that my term as Lord Regent has been extended through the month of harvest and potentially beyond. In addition, in this continuing crisis, the overseer...
Remain
in service to the state, and
garbage,
are empowered
garbage.
To enforce order whenever and wherever necessary. We owe our thanks to High Overseer Campbell for the generous loan of their services.
I think the materials are sad. Oh no, that's not a nice thing. Just garbage. Garbage, 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 garbage. All of it.
Be careful, Corvo. They call her Granny Rags. You wouldn't recognize her real name, or even the name of her family. But an emperor begged for her hand once, and rich young men fought each other for her favor. I watched her consider them all, measure their worth, and find them wanting. Then, she made a different choice. You're on your way to face the High Overseer, the leader of a great cult dedicated to loathing me. What will you do, I wonder?
Oh no, that's not a nice thing. Just garbage. Garbage, 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 garbage. All of it. If I was a birdie, I'd want to eat that. Yes, I would, indeed. I told you the knives go on the left. They've always gone on the left. You never listen. If I was a birdie, I'd want to eat that. Yes, I would, indeed. Dear? Is that you, my dear husband? My eyes aren't what they used to be. Have you seen my little birdies? Oh, the dear things must be starving without their granny. Here, birdies. Here. Oh, my, my, my. I think I have gentlemen callers again, but not the way I used to, not the nice ones. I hear them, and they're not very polite ones either. Granny Rags, let us in. Ah, well, they'll go away again if they know what's good for them, but what a bother. Here's the key to the front door, love. You'll see to those ruffians, won't you? I told you the knives go on the left. They've opened.
Let us in, Granny. I bet she can't even hear us. She's blind, not deaf. We're here to do your washing. She's not stupid either. Have it your way. We're here to take your money, Granny.
I told you. Oh, my dear. I knew you'd help me with those ill-mannered boys. My brave man. Listen, Granny has a birthday present for you. I got it from the outsider, and now I'm giving it to you. Go on. It's upstairs. On the vanity. I think you'll cut a nice figure with it. Remember how we used to dance? Our parties were even grander than those at the Boyle Manor. Everyone wanted to come. I think the little birdies are sad today. I hope you like the little gift I got for you. It's the least I could do for turning those louts away. I can't bear these Bottle Street children. Ruffians, every last one of them. Rotten apples. And that slack jaw is the worst of the lot. You know what I just thought of? You could do something else for me. Another little favor. And I'd give you another present. Another lovely rune carved from the bones of a dead whale. Do you remember my doctor, dear? Dr. Galvani? Now there was a clever man. He's got all sorts of nasty rat guts and disease in his laboratory. Wouldn't it be a shame if some of that mess found its way into the Bottle Street gang's elixir still? That'd teach him. See to it, dear. I'll find you another present just like the first. Galvani lives on Clavering Boulevard. Or at least he used to. Those were the days. Now run off. My baby birdies are hungry. So precious. But they're shy. You'll have to go or they won't come. If I was a birdie, I'd want to eat that. Yes, I would indeed. I think the little birdies are sad today. Here, birdies. Sweet birdies. Where did my birdies go? Maybe they should pay a visit to those young men. Wouldn't that be a surprise? Oh! There you are! Were you worried about your granny?
All these rats crawling all over.
You don't want to talk to us like that.
Fact is, Bottle Street is here to take its cut. So reach into your pockets, and let's get this done.
Yeah, and the inspection fee. We can't help it. Just the way we do things on Bottle Street.
Anyone there?
I'm trapped!
I owe you, brother. I want to ask about the mask.
I wouldn't want my face seen either, pulling a stunt like that.
You know what? I'll return the favor. Come by Griff's shop. That's my business. Well, it was, at one time. But now I'm reduced to scavenging things from here and there as the city dies. If you need anything, I wouldn't mind trading for a little money. Maybe someday the plague will blow over and everything will go back to normal. But until then, it's scavenging for me. Want to look at some of the things I found? Good prices, I swear. Those Bottle Street boys had no idea where I keep the best loot. Buy what you can.
Seen any more big rat swarms?
You're such a chopper.
Obviously, the plague rat is distinct from the ordinary rat, but in what respect? Its size and the coarseness of its fur, and I believe in intelligence, although the experiments there are not complete. Coriander's zoological survey describes only the ordinary rat, which means plague rats have only been here for 5 or 7 years at most. This was not a gradual migration. Could they have been introduced on purpose? Perhaps by a foreign power.
Did you touch the door handle to Dr. Galvani's lab?
Yeah, I think so.
Then you have to scrub. The rats get their vital essences
everywhere, the doctor said. Vital essences? Does that mean guts?
I think so. So your hands need scrubbing. I don't understand how Belmonte can admire so beloved. Royal physician or not, I hear Telly's a beast.
A superstitious philanderer who spends more time with prostitutes than he does in the laboratory.
Is this what it's going to be like when we're married? It is, isn't it?
I hope not. I'm telling you now, I don't have the endurance for it. I told her to keep the children inside. I told her. This whole place has gone to the hounds.
army of shadows in front of him.
That guy down? Ain't he just a boss? Like Slackjaw?
No. This is one odd bird. Consorts with crazies, does rituals and the like. Bone charms and such.
You sound afraid.
Damn right I am. Down ain't no ordinary man. Touched by the outsider he is, given dark powers. He can slit your throat across the room.
Well, that'd give him a leg up for sure.
It's no coincidence that most men won't even whisper his name.
Is it true that he lives in the flooded district, with them weepers and wild hounds?
That's what they say. Perfect place for a paid killer to hide.
To the Abbey or the office of the High Overseer, but one of the other places, where they train the overseers to be real religious.
Crazy.
He just wants to know where his brother's gone. He seeks him. You know where it is. Brilliant at it when he's sober.
Grimsley job, hitting the dumbwaiter all night.
Yeah. Goes from room to room. Kids sleeping. An overseer giving a lecture to the kids. A couple guys training. But it gives me some kind of machine. And a woman laughing. Just laughing and laughing. Then music. Kind of clinky, clonky sound.
That's an ace left, Rodney.
Okay, I got one for you.
Well, give it.
Okay, here goes. The nobleman laid with the scullery maid, so loudly they made quite a riot. The nobleman's wife took the butcher.
Carve yourself some easy.
Come on, let's get this guy. Let's see what's inside you. That's the end of you. Come on! Let's... What's going on over here? What? Damn it! Somebody! Must have been rats.
I knew you wouldn't disappoint me. Now I can stroll along the waterfront in peace. And don't think I've forgotten your little gift. Go on upstairs, dear one.